Have you ever noticed how mothers just seem to know what their babies need from a single cry? Or do they? Hi guys, Crystal here for DNews. I don't know about you, but I am terrified of babies. They scream, they cry, they don't use their words, and I want to help, but I can never quite seem to figure out what they want. But mothers just seem to know, even if it's not their kid that's doing the crying. What's up with that? It's almost as if mothers have a clairvoyant ability to perceive subtleties in the vocalizations of their offspring and pick up some imperceptible communication about whether a child is hungry, lonely, or in pain when all of us non-parents just hear screaming. Don't believe me? Just ask one, they'll tell you. But is this really true? Well, yes and no. Science has shown that the primal pull of a baby in distress is enough to reach across species. Mule deer mothers, yes, deer, we're talking about Bambi. Deer mothers that live in the wilds of the Canadian prairie quickly move towards recordings of infant deer distress sounds, but they also respond to the distress calls of animals they've never encountered before, like infant fur seals, dogs, cats, and even humans. Now, all of these species have distress calls at roughly the same pitch, so scientists concluded that there must be some evolutionary significance to the similarity of infant distress calls and to the maternal response to them. By the way, my favorite part of that experiment was that they showed that even the ultrasonic calls of infant bats attracted the deer mothers if scientists use software to lower their pitch to match the deer calls. So there's definitely evidence to support the maternal instinct to relieve a baby in distress. But come on, do you really know that that's your baby's hungry cry? Or are you inferring that from the time of day and the fact that you've tried everything else? Well, while I've had many a parent assure me that there is in fact some deep ability to non-verbally communicate with their infant child, science says, not really. A recent paper out of the Czech Republic tested this assertion by playing recordings of various human infant cries recorded from babies between 5 and 10 months of age. The researchers used both distress cries, like those associated with hunger, pain, and isolation, a non-distressed vocalization from infants that had just been reunited with a parent, just been fed, or were engaged in play. These sounds were played back for a sample of 333 subjects, composed of female and male adult humans, some but not all of whom were parents themselves, and the subjects were asked to classify the communications. Unsurprisingly, the data show that adult humans are universally able to differentiate a child's distress cry from any other vocalization, and are also really accurate at identifying the sounds of play, but that's where our abilities start to diverge. Being a parent slightly improved a subject's ability to differentiate the play situation and the hunger situation from any other, and younger subjects were simply better at classifying the sounds in general. But my favorite statement from the discussion section of this paper was, "Our results thus support the hypothesis that men and women are equally well predisposed to perceive and decode information from baby vocalizations." Surprising? Sorry guys, you're not off the hook. Men are just as capable of anticipating the source of an infant's cry as women. And don't let your spouse tell you any differently. So once again, science swoops in and casts doubt on socially held beliefs about human nature. No, we can't tell what our babies want just by hearing them cry. And women don't just know these things. So parents, go out there and do your best. It's no better or worse than anyone else could do. Also, I know some of you are thinking, I have the same reaction to vocalizations from my pet. Do I love my dog as much as my baby? Well, good news, science has an answer. There was a very important difference between a mother's response to her child and response to her dog. Areas of the midbrain associated with the dopamine reward circuit were only activated when a mother was looking at pictures of her own child. What do you think? Subscribe to DNews and let us know in the comments down below. Thanks for watching.